Hello friends, we have been looking into the current affairs issues for the prelims 2020 as part of the Crash Course series, and there is yet another important topic relating to how the questions are asked or the potential area of the question which we are going to see today is the anniversaries. See, basically when it comes to current affairs, there are certain things relating to anniversaries, such as what completes 5, basically I can start with 5 years, 5 years, 10 years, 25 years, 50 years, 75 years, 100 years, likewise. So I can say at times UPSC can also focus on 125 years anniversary and 150 years anniversary, 175 years anniversary and 200 years anniversary. These are all some of the areas of potential areas of questions. So look into those areas where, or look into those events which are relating to or which are celebrating its anniversaries. When I say anniversaries, it could be birth anniversary, or it could be death anniversary, or it could be the founding of any institution, or the completion of the happening of any event. So these kind of anniversaries or these kind of events are the questions where questions can be asked with respect to anniversaries. I hope you understand. Let us look into certain anniversaries of this year. We will look into the anniversaries and the potential areas of question. First and foremost, you see, 100th anniversary of non-cooperation movement. We all know that non-cooperation movement was launched in 1919. So from 1919 to 2019 is the 100 years. This 100 years, which are all the events, who are all the persons who either were born or who either died, or any sort of events or otherwise, whichever institution that has been found during this period, during this year, have to be taken into account for the anniversary. And for that matter, we will take up first the non-cooperation movement. Non-cooperation movement is basically, you know, is from history of freedom struggle, and nobody could have missed, and it is impossible to miss non-cooperation movement when you study history and Indian national freedom struggle. So focus on certain areas, as I had already told you in the previous videos, focus on the facts and concepts first relating to non-cooperation. So I don't have to teach you non-cooperation movement, otherwise current affairs class becomes a history class. So basically I am trying to tell you what are the potential areas of question from non-cooperation movement. So focus on the facts and concepts. What are the facts and concepts relating to non-cooperation? For instance, what do you mean by non-cooperation? Then what are the reasons why non-cooperation movement? That in which session of Congress non-cooperation movement was approved? It is a Nagpur session. This is a fact. What is non-cooperation? You know, right? Gandhi was of the view that when Gandhi returned from South Africa to India in 1915, he was of the view that his observation was the British could establish their empire in India, and British could set up their rule in India because of the cooperation that the Indians had given to them. So he said, we had cooperated for the British to come and do business here, but they have begun to rule us. So now we will begin to non-cooperate with them, so that they will have to get out, and because of that reason Swaraj will become possible, right? So Gandhi is of that view that instead of cooperating, when we cooperated, they could establish the empire. When we stop cooperating, they have to go out. So let us begin with non-cooperation. So that is the reason for non-cooperation. What is non-cooperation? Non-cooperation is not cooperating with the British with respect to the way they conduct the administration. Don't cooperate to conduct the administration. The students left the schools, the lawyers stopped practicing. For instance, Motilal Nehru gave a practice, C. Rajagopalachari gave a practice, Chittaranjan Das gave a practice, right? And the workers will go in for strike, so they will not produce. So this kind of non-cooperation. And this was approved in Nagpur session of the Indian National Congress. So this is a fact, whereas this is a concept. I hope you are able to understand this. Similarly, focus on the personalities. Who are all the important personalities involved in non-cooperation movement? Who were all supporting and who were all the most important persons? In fact, if you focus on that, Motilal Nehru used to be a person, then C.R. Das, right, these two are most important people, because remember, after the non-cooperation movement or subsequent to non-cooperation movement in 1923, while Gandhi wanted to avoid the council elections, these people will want to go for council election and they will be called as pro-changers. You know, while Gandhi and others were no changes, they were called as pro-changers. They launched, floated a political party, those things, Swaraj's party, you all know that. That I don't want to go into the history in detail, but focus on the personalities as well. Alright, so focus on non-cooperation movement. What were the different, how non-cooperation movement was taking place in the whole of the country, right? How it was happening in the cities, urban centers, and how it was happening in the rural areas. Focus on those areas as well. And similarly, along with this, see, non-cooperation movement is a kind of a sequel to Swadeshi movement. Actually, Swadeshi movement got stuck in 1905. Right, 1905 it started, and immediately after the Swadeshi movement, there were several aspects, and there used to be a doldrum. So between 1914 to 1919, that is where Gandhi entered, and focus on the events in these respects also. Remember, during 1918, 1919, or in the year 2014, the question was mostly asked from the World War I, because 1914 World War began, right? 1914 World War began, there were questions on World War I. Similarly, there could be a question relating to non-cooperation movement as well. Now, I am coming to another important point. What I am trying to tell you is, because of this World War and other stuff, other events that were happening, so the Swadeshi movement got suspended, and after that there used to be a doldrum. So there were several events that were happening between 1914 and 1919. So for example, Home Rule League. In fact, if you go back to the question, Home Rule League was asked in 2016. There were questions relating to Annie Besant. So because that was again anniversary, 100th anniversary of Home Rule League. So similarly, non-cooperation movement can also be asked, or focus on these events also. Importantly, I am trying to tell you, focus on these events also. These events also, what happened between 14 and 19. At times UPSC question setters have a kind of a thrilling mindset. The thrilling mindset is that they, instead of focusing on the 100 years, they will just focus on something that happened immediately before that. So instead of 1919, instead of non-cooperation movement, they may focus on Home Rule League. So you will be misconceived or you will be misled. When I am studying non-cooperation movement, because it is in current affairs, because it is celebrating its 100th anniversary, I am centenary celebration, I am focusing on over here. But unfortunately, the question came from Home Rule League. So all the materials have let me down. Likewise, you will feel that way, dejected. But remember, it is not so. UPSC has a sort of questioning pattern. In that questioning pattern, either they ask questions directly from the event which is celebrating its anniversary, or at times one step forward, one step forward, or one step backward. Meaning, at times they keep 1919 in the center. Instead of focusing on 1919, they may focus on the events that led to 1919, or they may focus on the consequences of the events that happened in 1919. What were the consequences of non-cooperation? That is the reason why I am telling you focus on these persons and pro-changes council entry plan. What was the happening relating to, or what did happen relating to the council entry plan? Kind of. So, focus on that as well. Because mark this word, non-obvious. When something is very obvious, there is not a possibility to test your personality. Meaning, when things are so open, right, when things are so open and when things are so public and common that anybody and everybody has the knowledge about it and everybody has an opinion about it, what is there to test by asking a question from that event with respect to, say, a civil services candidate? So, that is one of the important aspects that you must understand relating to the exam. So, sometimes the question setters may avoid things that are obvious. Secondly, they may avoid asking certain questions relating to certain events, because if it had a high potential for a question in the mains written exam. For example, non-cooperation movement, it's a huge area, it's a very vast area, there is a potential for mains, right? There are a number of questions that can be asked. At times they may choose to ask in both prelims and mains as well, that is different, but be careful. If they decide, because it is very obvious and there is no non-obvious thing to be asked, right? Even if it is obvious, there should be something non-obvious for you to go and catch. Only then it is a potential question. Otherwise, it does not have the value to be asked as a question. So, focus on these areas. And second, if it is having a very high potential for being asked as a question in the mains, probably they may avoid in prelims. Luckily, if you are lucky enough, they may ask it in both prelims and mains. That's up to your fortune. Anyway, that is a different issue. So, focus on events just before 1919, that is non-cooperation. What led to the events that led to non-cooperation movement, and also the consequences of the non-cooperation movement. So, this is one important aspect of anniversary. Along with this, remember, just immediately before non-cooperation movement, there was something called as Rowlatt Act. Fine, let us go into Rowlatt Act little later. Give me few seconds. Have you understood what non-cooperation movement is and what anniversary is? I hope you would have understood that. Now, let us focus on the Rowlatt Act as well, because it is also relating to 1919. In fact, it was preceding Rowlatt Act was preceding the non-cooperation movement, launch of non-cooperation movement. Now, in this, again, Rowlatt Act is also 100th year. So, here there are two different aspects here. It is the 100th anniversary of the Act and also the 100th anniversary of anti-Rowlatt Act Satyagraha. Remember, this is a very potential question, right? Very, very potential question. Satyagraha as a tool in India first comes into be used by Gandhi in a big way, in a major way, in a nationalistic movement, was in Rowlatt Act Satyagraha. Fine. So, these two anniversaries are there, both are in 1919. So, along with this, you have to focus on two aspects again. we have to focus on the main feature of the act. What is the main feature of the act? Why this act is called as draconian provision? Focus on that. Then focus on the main events of anti-Rowlatt Act Satyagraha. What are the main events? Right? One of the most important main event is what is known as the Punjab Bronx or the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. The Jallianwala Bagh massacre and General Dyer ordering his police force to open fire upon unarmed protesters who were gathered in a enclosed space called the Jallianwala Bagh. So focus on these areas. What is the main event? What are the main features? And what are the main events of anti-Rowlatt Act Satyagraha? This again, this is also celebrating its 100th year. I hope you this much is enough. Otherwise, I don't have to tell you what are all the other aspects or major features relating to this. It will become a history class. Let me not go into that. Let us not do that. But focus on NCERT books contain this, and any history book contains issues relating to this. Please do focus on them. Then the third aspect relating to 1919 is the Khilafat movement. So the Khilafat movement, again Khilafat movement, it, in fact we will be calling it as non-cooperation and Khilafat movement. This is a combination of movement. Right, it is a combination of movement, non-cooperation and Khilafat movement. This is also belonging to the year of 1919. Focus on this as well, the Shaukat Ali and Muhammad Ali, the brothers who started the Caliph Khilafat movement, which Gandhi wanted the Khilafat movement to be included into the non-cooperation movement. And remember, this is one of the important events which led to the Hindu-Muslim divide in Indian history. Because after the Chauri Chaura incident of 1922, Gandhi suspended non-cooperation movement, with which the Khilafat movement also got suspended, which actually led to the Hindu-Muslim divide. And one of the landmarks in the history of India and the Indian national freedom struggle. Anyway, focus on that. These are all the things which you will be finding in the NCERT books as well. So 1919 is an year of anniversary. 2019, with the 2019, 100 years complete from 1919. So the events that took place in 1919 assumes importance. They are in current affairs. Though these are all the things which whatever we have discussed is belonging to history, they have a value of current affairs. So please do focus on that, and let us continue with other anniversaries in the next upcoming videos. Thank you very much, and if you had not subscribed, please do subscribe to this video, and we shall travel together and reach heights and come out with flying colors in the civil service examinations. Wish you all the best, and thank you, friends.